Hi, my name is Chris Kimura, and I've been a Cardiff and Encinitas resident since the year 1978. I've had a huge passion for surfing since the age of 11, but unfortunately I haven't been able to surf in 20 years. I wanted to share my story with the hopes of inspiring and encouraging other cancer patients to have a positive attitude, to live life to the fullest, and also know that someone else out there has it worse off than we do. In 1994, I was diagnosed with a very rare disease, Castleman's disease. It's such a rare disease, there's only 200 reported cases a year in the country alone. I once had a second opinion by a UCLA oncologist, and his bedside manner wasn't very good. He actually told me that he hated Castleman's patients worse than cancer patients. I knew then that this was serious. In 1997, my Castleman's disease became more aggressive. My hemoglobin level dropped to 6.6, which one's hemoglobin level should be between the ranges of 12.5 to 18.5% of their blood plasma. I also had compromised lungs. I had cystic and fibrotic damage throughout both my lungs. One of the side effects from having such a low hemoglobin and compromised lungs is I was sleeping 24 to 36 hours straight. I was barely able to walk up a flight of stairs without passing out, and I was really scared. That being said, I was having a real difficult time. I couldn't really walk. I love to play golf. I couldn't walk from my golf court to the green. I couldn't exercise at the gym anymore. I couldn't go on my 8-mile runs that I used to love to do. And I lost my passion of surfing, which I really loved. And once you're a surfer and you lose that passion, it's almost like you lose part of your soul. And I think the biggest thing is I didn't know what my lifespan would be. And that, again, really, really was a big concern and had me really scared. Since 1997, I've been through a multitude of chemo treatment plans. The reason being is that eventually, each one of these plans that I've been on, the drug would lose its efficacy and the symptoms of my disease would return and the quality of my life would revert back to how it was before. But then in the year 2007, a great family friend, along with my oncologist, Dr. James Sinclair, played an integral role in getting me a non-compassionate use IND of a new chemotherapy drug, not yet approved in the United States, but approved in Japan and the UK, and they were able to deliver me this new drug treatment, which has saved my life, and I am very grateful to both my great family friend and Dr. James DeClaire for always being there for me. 20 years later, the year is now 2014, I have proven the statistics wrong. I truly am a real-life miracle. I feel very blessed for everything that has been bestowed upon me, both good and the bad. My life has really flourished with the bad, and the way that I look at it, there's a silver lining in every cloud. I'm able to self-actualize at a faster pace and give back and pay it forward. I am forever indebted to my great family friend who has given me this life extension, along with my entire medical team, Scripps Health and Dr. James DeClaire again, for always being there with me for the past 20 years. So my goal of sharing my story is to help others reach their successes, their goals, and also to enjoy every day as it comes and live in the moment and do the best that they can and enjoy life. One of the biggest blessings in the past 20 years goes to Mike Raley and his invention of the wave jet. With the invention of the wave jet, I'm able to relive my passion that I had for surfing. Last weekend, I had such a good time. I caught one of the biggest waves I've caught in 20 years and was really, really happy and stoked about surfing again. I'm living my life to the fullest for all my chemo club friends who can't and or are no longer here with us today. I'm doing this for you and living my life to the fullest for you. So I hope this story inspires people not to take for granted everyday life, and if they can, pay it forward, give back, and think about those less fortunate than we are. Thank you. Good morning. What a beautiful day it is today. It is 9 a.m. I'm at the Scripps Medical Office building in La Jolla, California, and I'm here for my every other Tuesday chemotherapy infusion for Castleman's disease. Let's go in.
Vicky's just cackling over there.
Thank you. See what a good job she does? She's a perfectionist.
I can see.
She needs a raise.
Awesome.
Mm-hmm. All right. Oh, I need a cup of water first so I can have the dexamethasone.
Okay, we're here with Dr. Sinclair and one of his many patients, Chris Kimura. Dr. Sinclair, how long have you been treating this prize patient of yours?
Chris and I have been together since 1994. 20 years. It's been amazing.
What has been the amazing part about the treatment that you've been a part of?
Well, statistically, he had a pretty advanced disease that had a very troublesome prognosis. But very quickly, with the help of a lot of good doctors, not just myself, we were able to gain good control of his disease. And since that time, we've been blessed by new drugs. And over the last 20 years, Chris has had several medications. But most recently, some exciting new drugs that were developed both in Japan and here in the U.S. And what we find amazing is that as we continue to use these medications, his disease continues to improve, and his performance, which is how he functions on a daily basis, also continues to improve. And I think one of the things we were shocked by is that even some of the scars that formed in relationship to the disease have healed. So he's a remarkable physical specimen. With a great family and a great belief system, and I think that he and I speak the same language.
From the standpoint of your other patients, what can they take away from this example in terms of the hope aspect? How do you transmit a hope that allows your patients to enjoy the perspective and prognosis for future quality of life?
Well, the first thing I tell them is that medicine is evolving rapidly. We live in a country where the technology is phenomenal, both diagnostically and therapeutic. So medications keep coming. So be patient. We may be able to control your disease long enough until something dramatic comes along that really does it. And I think that's what's happened with Chris, and it can happen with a number of patients. So even though the initial prognosis may be dismal, if you can be patient and we can work together and maintain that degree of optimism, eventually we may find the right recipe for you. And even if we don't, the sense of that you're working together and that you're using all the tools that we have available, I mean, that's really what matters. And I think that for all my patients, whether they live 6 months or 60 years, to have that sense that they're participating, that we're using everything available, both from a traditional standpoint, as well as all of the integrative approaches. And I think that lifestyle matters a lot. And I think Chris has a great attitude about lifestyle. You have to get out there in the world, and he does it very well.
Dr. Sinclair, thank you for your time.
You're welcome.
Faster than you, you don't really know what to do. Do you think that you're not alone? You really think that you're immune to it's gonna get the best of you? It's gonna lift you up and let you down. It will defeat you, then teach you to get back up after it takes away. Thank you. will teach you to love what you're afraid of. After it takes away all that you learn to love. But you don't always have to hold your head higher than your heart. You better hope you're not.
Inventing the weekend. Had a great time out there for Tuesday. Mentally, I'm so healthy right now. I'm stoked with Inventing the Weekend. Thank you.